Hey guys, what's up people? Good evening. How are you all doing? Long time no see. How's everyone? Missed you all now. How's everything going? How's life people? Hi Archie, hi Surya, hi Devapita, hi Swayam. What's up? Welcome back. How was your day so far? What's new in life? How is everything going? I know it's been a long time. I feel like it's been forever since we have last met, but it was a lot of technical issues, people. That's why I could not come live. But nonetheless, how are you guys doing? I'm great. Thank you for asking. How are you people doing? Good, Sam. Good to know. Hi, Surya. Welcome. I'm good, Kushi. Thank you for asking. How are you doing? Hi, Shani. I'm good. Hi, Devita. I'm good. Hi, Archie. Good evening. So, yeah, people, what's up? What has changed in the last, I don't know, 1 week that we have not met? Anything new that has happened? Anything, you know, anything exciting? Anything that you would like to share? Or it's been the same how it has been for the past 1 year? Yeah? Anything exciting? Something. At least say that you went out. Nothing. Same year, people. Yeah, David, I missed you guys too. Welcome back. Pre-votes. Yeah, that's good news. Anyways, welcome to today's session. My name is Anoop and this is Vedantu. I sincerely hope that all of you guys are doing good. And I'm really sorry that I was not able to come live for the past 1 week due to a lot of technical reasons. So, to make it all up, today is going to be the fifth session of Work, Power and Energy for CBSE 9th. And today, we will be talking about power and energy. So without wasting any more time, welcome to today's session. Power and commercial unit of energy is what our focus is going to be on. But before we get started, can you guys tell me how many of you were there in the last session that we had? In the previous session of work, power, energy, how many of you guys have attended that or how many of you guys saw the replay of that? You did? So I'm all right. Because the reason why I'm asking you people is because from now on, all the live sessions, before I start the live session, I'll also be going through a quiz of what we did in the previous session. So we'll have three questions from the previous, previous session, what all we did. So get ready for that. So quickly join your Mentimeter, people. We are going to call this round the backtrack round just to see how many of you guys remember what we did in the previous session. So quickly join the Mentimeter. The code is 4779368 and... once you're in, let me know so we can get started. All right. So this is how it's going to be from now on. Every live session, I'll be asking you questions from the previous session. So make sure that you watch the video of that so that you can answer these questions as well. Because ultimately, these will also be added to your final leaderboards, right? So go ahead, people. Come on. I'm good, Anjali. Thank you for asking. Watch the replay, Surya. Congratulations. Nice. Now, hi, Shubhi. What's up? Welcome. I know. Veda Gopal. I know, Gauri. It's been very, very, very long time. I can see that with the... I know the number. I can see that it's been a long time because there was a lot of technical reasons, people. There was no power in my place for the past 1 week. There was some technical, they were doing some maintenance issues and all that. So maintenance repairs. So because of that reason, I don't have any power at all. But yeah, I'm back now. I'm back with the bang. All right, I'm good. Sugam, Sanushri, how are you doing? Welcome. Hi, Anjali. Hi, Karthi. Quickly join the Mentimeter, people. I'll be starting the quiz in another probably 10 seconds. Quickly join the Mentimeter once you're in. Let me know so we can get started, all right? So I'm going to give you another 10 more seconds. I know, even I missed you guys too. Welcome. Hi, Samuel. What's up? Quickly join the Mentimeter. All right, I'm going to start the quiz in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's go. First question. Take a look at this one. Let's go. The question is... if a body is falling from a height h, after it has fallen h by 2, it will possess only potential energy, only kinetic energy, half potential and half kinetic energy, or more kinetic and less potential energy. When the ball is being dropped or an object is ball dropped from a height h and it has come halfway through, that is h by 2, what would happen to the mechanical energy possessed by the system? That is, would it have only potential energy, only kinetic energy, half potential, half kinetic, or more kinetic and less potential? Okay, let's see. Oh, brilliant. Good stuff, people, good stuff. That is an amazing start. And yes, definitely yes, it will contain half potential and half kinetic energy. Let me just quickly take you through how to solve this question. It's actually pretty simple, people. So height is h by 2, MGH is your potential energy U. So here MGH will be MGH by 2. That's MGH whole divided by 2 is what is your potential energy. Kinetic energy is what? Kinetic energy is half mv square. So half mv square you do not know. So use the third equation of motion. V square is equal to U square plus 2gh. So here it's h by 2. That is what is going to happen. So 2 gets cancelled. U is 0 because initial velocity of the ball is 0 plus gh. So v square you'll get it as gh. Now substitute that over here. So you'll get it as into gh. So you'll get it as half or mgh divided by 2. So basically it's equal. That is what is they are trying to say. So kinetic energy will be equal to potential energy. So whatever is the value of kinetic energy, the potential energy value will also be the same when it's reached halfway through. Brilliant start, people. Brilliant start. I don't know how many people took a guess, but still that is a good guess, people. But in the exam, I don't want to guess, it's just guess. Do it, solve it, and show the teacher that you know the answer. All right. Anyways, Swayam on the first, followed by Abhishek sir. Bless us, people. Then we have Praneel, followed by Aryan. Then it's Shubhi, Praneet, Heartstorm, Avinash, Kartike. Let's rock, yeah, buddy. Then it's Barefoot, Contessa as well. Congratulations, people. Congratulations. Good start. Moving on to the second question of the backtrack round. Here is the second question. Take a look at this one. Let's go. Get ready. Here it is. When a body falls freely towards the earth, then its total energy increases, decreases, remains constant, or first increases and then decreases. When a body is falling down freely towards the earth, then its total energy increases, decreases, remains constant, or first decreases and then increases. Let's go! 13 more seconds. Let's go. Hello. Hi, Ranjini. What's up? Rajni. What's up? So, Prasoon, yes. Yeah, we'll be coming live there. Don't worry, Prasoon. Because of technical issues, I was not able to come live last week. But this week, I'll be coming live. Don't worry. All right, so 18 of you guys were able to give the right answer for this one. Much better than the previous question as well. Beautiful, people. Beautiful. Absolutely correct. Kinetic energy plus potential energy is always going to be constant at any point, when the body is falling down. So it's always going to remain same. The total mechanical energy or the total energy of the system will always remain constant. It's never going to change. No matter what body it is, when it's falling freely under the influence of gravity, its total energy will always remain constant, right? Beautiful, guys. Moving on to the leaderboards at the end of that second question. We have one more question for the background round, and then we'll move on to the regular session, all right? So yes, Swayam followed by Abhishek, sir. Then it's Praneel, Aryan, Shubhi, Praneet, Avinash, Shubhi, Surya, Arshi, the new students. Welcome to today's session. And we also have Samuel as well. Congratulations, Praneel. Beautiful, buddy. Fastest to answer. Moving on to the last question for the backtrack round. Here it is, people. The last and the final question for the day. For the first quiz time. Here it is. A ball is dropped from a height of 10 meters. All right. Simple. The options are: its potential energy increases and kinetic energy decreases during the fall. Its potential energy is equal to the kinetic energy during the fall. Its potential energy decreases and kinetic energy increases during the fall. The potential energy is zero and kinetic energy is maximum while it is falling. Dun, dun, dun. Again, repeat the options again. Its potential energy increases, kinetic energy decreases. Its potential energy and kinetic energy is equal. Its potential energy decreases, kinetic energy increases. My God, people. My God, you guys are all rock stars. Yeah? Once again, that's almost every single question. I think we got over 90% answers, right answers. Beautiful, guys. Give her a big round of applause to yourself. That is an amazing, amazing, amazing effort from your side. And definitely, yes, people, as the ball is, see, when it's at the maximum height, potential energy is maximum. As it's falling down, the potential energy getting slowly starts converted to, it'll slowly start to convert it to kinetic energy. And just before it hits the ground, the kinetic energy is going to be maximum. Potential energy at that point is going to be zero. Beautiful, guys. Beautiful. Here is your leaderboard at the end of that third question. And we'll again come back to this. So do not, exit the mentimeter. Once we do the topic, which will take about 15 to 20 minutes, we'll again come back to the quiz as well. So don't leave it. Nonetheless, here's your leaderboard at the end of the time. At this time, we have Abhishek sir on the top. Obviously, we did not expect anything less from Abhishek sir. Following Praneel, it's Aryan, Swayam, Praneet, Avinash, Surya, Archie, Samuel, and Milky Shri as well. What a name, Milky Shri, fastest to answer, congratulations. But nonetheless, that is a good number, guys. That is a good number. With that said, let's get back to the topic. Everyone, focus up, alright? Let's talk about power, alright? Let's understand the topic first. And then again, based on these things, we'll again come back to the questions. Alright. So before we get started, can I have two volunteers, people? Can I have any two volunteers? Any two Balika Bakra? Anyone? Anyone? No one? Come on. At least there should be two of them. Two of you guys from out of this gang. Yeah. All right, Devpita, you want to do it? All right, anyone else? Sindhu, all right, so Devpita and Sindhu, all right, so we have Devpita and Devpita and was that Sindhu also, no? Sindhu, all right, now, all right, imagine this, imagine world heavyweight competition, you know, where they have to lift up the weights. Devpita and Sindhu are the competitors. Now, here's the thing. Two people, Devpita and Sindhu. I hope you guys can see the GIF. I can't see it for some reason. I hope you can see it. You can see that two people are lifting up this weights. It so happens that Devpita takes a little bit more time to lift it up. Right? She's like struggling to lift up that weight. But Sindhu just lifts it up like it's nothing. Right? So she just lifts it up really, really fast. So we have two people lifting. Say, I don't know what is happening to the GIF, but I hope you can see it. For one person is taking a little bit, person A is taking a little bit more time. Like he's, you know, struggling. Devpita is struggling to lift the weight up. But Sindhu, on the other hand, is just lifting up in one shot. All right. Now, if you look at it carefully, one person, that is person A, Devpita, took more time in comparison to Sindhu, who took less time. All right. This is the only difference. So if I ask you this question, what do you think about the work done? Is the work done different in both the cases, or do you think it's the same? Is it different or is it the same? Think carefully and tell me, guys. Think carefully. Is the work done going to be different or is it going to be the same? You can't see, you know. I can't see it. I know what is happening right now. All this while it was working fine. Well, exactly. All right. Some of you guys are saying same. Anyone else who has anything else? Thank you, Sejal. Thanks a lot, buddy. Welcome. Absolutely, guys. Work done is going to be same. You know why? Because work done, what is the formula of work done? Work is equal to force into displacement. And in both the cases, because they are reaching the same height, the work done is going to be the same. So what's different then? What is different about them? The time taken. One person is taking more time, whereas the other is taking less time. So there is one quantity that defines work done, not just with respect to displacement, but also with respect to time. That quantity is what is called as power. In the most simplest term, power is nothing but work done by time taken. That's all. Whatever is the work done with respect to, because in work done, we don't consider the time at all. But if you consider the time taken as well to do some whatever the task is, that is what is called as power. In the most simplest term, that is what is power. So in this case, because Sindhu or person B is taking less amount of time to lift it up, to lift up the load, she will be said to have more power compared to, or she's applying more power, or she's exerting more power in comparison to Devpita, who's person number one, who's exerting less power. That's all. What is power? Work done per unit time. Right, people? Did everyone understand this? Did you understand one of the most basic concepts of power? Did you understand this? Is it clear? So what is work done? Sorry, what is power? Work done per unit time is what is power. That's all. Simple. So if you have to write down the formula, what is the formula? Simple. Okay, what is this? I'm drawing something. All right. So power is equal to work done divided by the time taken. That's work done divided by time taken. This is what it is. P is equal to W by T, where W represents work done and T is nothing but time. Right. Now, let's talk about the unit of this. What do you think would be the unit? All right. Can anyone tell me what is the unit of work done? In the chat box, anyone who can challenge and tell me what is the unit of work done, what challenge is already low about it. So what is it? So how do you know that the person is a she? It's imagination. Exactly, guys. The unit of power is nothing but joules per second. The SI unit of work done is joules. The SI unit of time is second, so joules per second, which we write it as watts. This is what joules per second is nothing but what. So when you talk about machines, why do we prefer machines over people? Because machines can do the work faster. So what is power telling you? Power measures the speed of work done, how fast something is getting done. Because obviously, guys, think about people. People get tired, people need break, but machines don't need that. But all you have to do, you have to make sure that is that machine is well oiled, and you have to make sure that there's no overheating. Until that does not happen, machine can do that same work much more faster. That's why we're getting into a more automated, we're getting into more automated industries because of the same reason. So what is power? It's nothing but work done by time. SI unit is joules per second, which we write it as watt. Simple. And if you're asked to define, which is definitely a one mark question, what is 1 watt? Very simple. Work done is said to be 1 watt when 1 joule of work is done in 1 second. This is what you have to do. Just put it as 1 over here, 1 over here, 1 over here. So 1 watt of work is done. 1 watt of work is done when 1 joule of energy, of 1 joule of work is done in 1 second. So 1 watt. The power is said to be 1 watt when 1 joule of work is done in 1 second. That's all right, guys. So that's how you define that. It's an easy one mark question right in your pockets. And yes, people, remember this formula: power is equal to work by time. If you remember that, that is pretty much more than enough for you to remember that, for you to score those simple, one mark and two mark questions regarding the same as well. All right. Now, if you've ever been to an electrical shop to buy bulbs or to buy tube lights, they'll ask you how many watts do you want. They won't ask you, do you want 5 centimeter long or 10 centimeter long. They'll tell you if you want a 20 watt bulb, 40 watt bulb, 60 watt bulb, or a 100 watt bulb. Have you wondered what is this? How many of you have actually thought about this? Like, before me saying this, how many of you have actually thought about all of this? That, why do they ask it in terms of what? Why not something else? Why not the length, or why not the energy consumption? Why only in terms of power? How many people have actually thought about it? Seriously? All right. Okay. Interesting. Okay. Now, tell me this, guys. If you just look at the number and tell me, which do you think has more power? The 60 watt bulb or the 100 watt bulb? Which one do you think will have more power? 60 or 100? All of you guys are like full on geniuses. 100 watt? Okay. How many of you guys? Everyone 100 watt? All right. But why? Why 100 watt? Why 60 watt? Why not 60 watt? Why? What does this represent? This shows that a 60 watt bulb means that it is consuming 60 joules, or it is doing a work of 60 joules, or converting 60 joules of energy in 1 second of time to light energy. But here, it means that it's converting 100 joules of energy, or it's consuming 100 joules of energy in 1 second. That is what it means. So obviously, because the power consumption of this 100 watt bulb is more, you can say that this has more power in comparison to this. So this consumes 60 joules, and this is consuming 100 joules in 1 second. So if you talk about this, which do you think will be more brighter, 60 watt or 100 watt? Then you just told me in terms of energy consumption. Can you think and tell me which of them do you think will be more brighter if one is 60 watt and the other is 100 watt? Definitely 100 again. Absolutely wonder people. Why? Because here in this 100 watt, 100 joules of electrical energy is getting converted to light energy. Here it's much more less, and it's just 60 joules getting converted to light energy, and hence you can say that 100 watt is going to be much more brighter than the 60 watt bulb. Simple as that. Did everyone understand this? Give me a quick, oh yeah. Did you understand this? Is it clear so far? Everything good? Enjoy? All good? Easy topic? Super easy, no? So what trumper? All good, no? What is LED? LED is nothing but light emitting diode. That is different, all right? Yeah, done. Awesome. Heating effective electrical is a power. It is just a waste. It is just, see, your intention in using these incandescent bulbs is not to heat up the room. Your intention is to produce light. It's just a wastage of energy. Heating effective electrical is like basically the filament heats up and all of that. That's wasting. That's just wasting that 60 joules. It's not like all of that 60 joules is getting converted to light energy. That does not happen. But because 100 joules is more than 60 joules, obviously, even though it loses some amount of energy in the form of heat, it'll still be much more brighter in comparison with 60 watt. Got it? Yeah, people, that's it. All right. So this is it, people. This is what we've understood so far. With this, we have one more topic, and then we'll come back to the quiz again. So this is the topic that we learned so far. What is it? Work done in unit time, or basically the rate of doing work is what is power. The formula is power is equal to work done by time. The unit is joules per second, which we wrote it as watt. And what is 1 watt? 1 watt of the power is said to be 1 watt when 1 joule of work is done in 1 second. That's it. All right. Now, one of the most important topics we're going to talk about: commercial unit of energy. See guys, at your homes right now, as we speak, you might have a fan turned on. You're using probably a laptop or a computer which is probably connected to a socket. You have probably your lights turned on. Your refrigerators might be turned on. Maybe your mom is cooking right now in a microwave oven. Your TV might be turned on. The other fans might be turned on. A lot of electrical equipment are being run every single day as we speak. A lot of this, right? So all of these also require a lot of electrical energy as well, because obviously it cannot run on its own. It's not like self-sustaining that it's doing all on its own. No, as long as electrical energy is there is an electrical supply, that electrical energy is what is getting converted to all these different forms in all these electrical equipments. So how do you calculate this electrical energy that we consume? Let's talk about that, because it's very important. Trust me guys, if you understand this concept, no, you can actually calculate how much is your electric bill every month. You can actually state, you know, why are you getting charged so much? Like, why are you paying 1000 rupees or 2000 rupees as your electric bill? You will be able to figure out the answer for that. It's such an amazing thing to do. Trust me, like, you can impress your parents with that. All right, now imagine a refrigerator. All right, so they've told that the energy consumption is 50 watt. All right, the power is said to be 50 watt, not energy consumption. They've told us the power is said to be 50 watt. So what does 50 watt mean? That means it's consuming 50 joules in 1 second. That is what it means. We've just stated that power is nothing but work by time. So work, that, what does that mean? If power is 50 watt, that means 50 joules of energy is getting consumed in 1 second. Now, let's say that this refrigerator is running for 24 hours a day. Like, the person does not turn it off at all, and for 365 days, for 24 hours, for 365 days also. So all throughout the year, you are keeping this refrigerator on. Now, if I want to calculate what is the energy consumed, what is the energy, the electrical energy consumed by this refrigerator, how will I calculate it? Very, very simple. What is the consumption of electrical energy? It's nothing but, if I have to calculate in terms of joules, how will I calculate it? So this thing, the energy consumed by this is 50 joules. 50 joules into how many hours is it running? 24 hours a day. What is 1 hour? 1 hour is nothing but 60 minutes. What is 1 minute? 60 seconds. So into 60. If you multiply this with 365, you will get the energy consumed by this one single refrigerator in terms of joule, which is going to be a very big value. So you are going to get a value like this, which is massive. Look at that. It's like, how many zeros are there? Like 5 zeros. This thing is like massive. So much amount of energy is getting consumed. In terms of joules, you are able to say that so much amount of energy is getting consumed. Now, look at this, guys. It's a very big unit. It's a very big unit. So you can't just say it so easily. It's much more hard for you to tell, you know, how many zeros and all of that. So instead of using joules, which is a smaller quantity to represent the energy consumed, we use a larger quantity called as kilowatt hour. Instead of using joules, we use this thing, a larger quantity called as kilowatt hour. So rather than representing in terms of joules, which is a very, very big value, which every single time would show you a value which is like, you know, in trillions and all that, rather than doing that, we represent all of that in terms of kilowatt hour. Now remember this, guys, 1 kilowatt is equal to 1000 watt, right? Kilo is like 1000, right? So 1 kilowatt is equal to 1000 watt. So 1 kilowatt hour is equal to 1000 watt hour, all right? So 1 watt is equal to 1000, or 1/1000 kilowatt hour, or you can say that 1 kilowatt is equal to 1000 watt hour, sorry, watt, and 1 kilowatt hour is equal to 1000 watt hour. Simple, clear so far? Now, what we're gonna do is, we're gonna do a small derivation, all right? So what did we just state so far? We know that 1 kilowatt hour is equal to 1000 watts into 1 hour. That is what it means, right? Because one kilo, remember this, 1 kilowatt 1 kilowatt is equal to 1000 watt. So in place of that, I'm writing it as 1 kilowatt hour, which is nothing but 1000 watt hour. Now what is 1 watt? It is nothing but joules per second. 1 joule per second, that is what it means. So I have 1 joule per second, and what is 1 hour? 1 hour in terms of seconds is what? 1 hour 60 minutes into 60 seconds, which is what? 3600 seconds, right? So I have 1 hour, which is in terms of seconds, is 3000 seconds, and 1 watt. 1 kilowatt is equal to 1000 watt. So I can write this as 1000 joules per second into 3600 seconds. Seconds gets cancelled. So what are you left with? 1600000, which I can represent it as what? So this is joules. This is in terms of joules. So this, instead of writing it like this, I can write it as 3.6 into 10 to the power of 6 joules. So people, what I'm trying to say is this. 1 kilowatt hour. 1 kilowatt hour is equal to 3.6 into 10 to the power of 6 joules. Got it? Did you understand this, people? Is everyone clear with it so far? Exactly, now, exactly. Clear? That's all, people. So if you are ever given a value like this, for example, the same thing that we just calculated right now, that whatever that is, whatever the value was of this, if you divide this by 3.6 into 10 to the power 6, you will get it in terms of kilowatt hour, which is nothing but 438 kilowatt hour. Simple ways. That's how easy it is. So if you're given a big value like this in terms of joules, divide that value by 3.6 into 10 to the power 6 joules, and you'll get it in terms of kilowatt hour. Why? Because 1 kilowatt hour is equal to 3.6 into 10 to the power 6 joules. So obviously, if you want to calculate it in terms of kilowatt hour, just divide the value by this. That's how you'll get it. So you can write this as units. So this, instead of writing it as kilowatt hour, this also means that it has consumed 438 units. So if they ask you in the question that you should write it in terms of units, it's nothing new. Whatever you write it as kilowatt hour, that itself is the unit consumption as well. So that is nothing but units. So here, if the energy consumption is 438 kilowatt hour, you can write it as 438 units. That's it. Right, guys? So that is pretty much it, people. That is pretty much it. So your electric meter that you have just calculates the same thing. So if in case the next time you see an electric bill and they've told you, that is mentioned that you've consumed so and so units, you can actually calculate how much you're getting charged and how much energy consumption is happening every single day as well. So this is the final thing I would like to say. Kilowatt hour is the unit of energy used to express the energy used in households, industries, and commercial establishments as well. Because if you represent in terms of joules, it's a very big value. So rather than that, we represent it in terms of kilowatt hour, right, guys? So before we get into the quiz time, people, before we get into the last and the final quiz time, the topic is done. I hope everyone understood this. Before we get into that, if you want to enjoy these kind of sessions and have a lot of fun and learn with the best of the best teachers on one of the best online platform there is, all you have to do, if you want to be a part of us, click on the link that is given in the description as well as in the pinned comment section as well. Let me tell you what are the advantages, what are the things that you're getting out of it. You are getting an opportunity to learn with the best of the best teachers and learn unlimited number of times. You can attend how many of the sessions you want during that duration. How many of you want to attend 20 sessions in a day? Go ahead and do it, people. Nobody's going to stop you. Unlimited live classes with the highest and highest level of quizzes, just like this one, but in a much more detailed way. You'll have fastest fingers list. You will have leaderboards of in every single session and every single quiz as well. And every session is going to be fun filled, where you get to enjoy and study at the same time. With this, you have the opportunity to compete with the rest of the world, because obviously when you're taking up quizzes, you're not just attending sessions with the people from your state or from the neighboring states, but the entire country, in fact the entire world as well. So you can actually compete with the rest of the world and see what you are or where you are good at. With this, you also have the interactive replay sessions. So if in case you miss out a session, don't worry, you can still take the quiz, you can still see the leaderboard and see where you would have been at if you were to attend that session. And added to this thing, people, you can download all the premium content of every single session, watch the replays of every single session that happens, and get every handwritten note of every single class that you ever attend. With this, you also have the opportunity to get your doubts cleared inside the session itself. You will not just have one teacher to solve your doubts and to help you understand the concept, but you'll have two teachers inside the class, master teacher and the class teacher, to help you clear every single doubt of yours. With that, you'll also have all the tests and assignments available to you for your practice, because you know that you have hardly 4 months left. I know hardly is not the right word, but still, 4 months, you might think that it's a lot of time, but think about it, guys. When you started the year, Jan also felt like a long time. Now you're at Jan and now you're feeling like, when your exam is going to start, like 4 months from now, that is also a long time. But it's not actually the case. The time will go just like that. So make sure that you practice as many number of tests and assignments as you can. And to make that possible, we'll also be giving you unlimited number of tests and assignments to, you know, help you improve every single day. And with that, 5,000 plus micro courses and crash courses, all for free. All of this and a lot more, all you gotta do is click on the link that is given in the description as well as in the pinned comment section, people. The coupon code is AME Pro to avail your discounts. Why is this coupon code so necessary? Let me tell you that. If you go for the 1 month program, the base price of that is $2,699, which is a lot of money. If you want to save some money, enter the coupon code AME Pro. This is my coupon code AME Pro. You get a discount of about 500 rupees and the price comes down to 2,159 rupees. If you go for the 3 month program, which I would suggest you do, that will be around 6,999, that's around 7,000 rupees. If you use the coupon code AME Pro, you get a discount of 1,400 and the price drops down to 5,599 rupees. If you just think about it, guys, just think about it for a second. I know that 2,000 and 5,000 things, they don't seem like a lot of money, but in that 2 months or in that 3 months or in that 1 month duration, in that 1 month, you'd have attended a minimum of 250 sessions, and in that 3 months, you'd have attended a minimum of 750 sessions, which means that per session, you're paying about 9 rupees. And if you go for the 3 month program, you're paying about 7.5 rupees per session. And the more number of sessions you take, the lesser amount of money you're actually paying per session, which is actually less than basically a packet of rice. See, guys, our intention is to make sure that every nook and corner of this country deserves quality education. And yes, it might seem like a lot of money, but think about it. It's actually a lot less, when you are thinking about your own future for your own, board exams and stuff, right? So it's for your own future. It's an investment for your own future. So check out the link that is given in the description as well as in the pinned comment section. And the coupon code is AME Pro. With that said, let's get into the quiz, people. That's it. Let's get on to the Mentimeter. Quickly join the Mentimeter. Q&A questions. Let's go. The code is 4779368. Quickly join the Menti and then we shall begin. About 40 of you guys here. I want everyone to join quickly, people. So now I'm also, is it Arya Viraj? Congratulations. Welcome, welcome, welcome to the world, buddy. All right. Okay. Hi, Sonam. What's up? People, any doubts that I missed out? Nothing, right? All right. Welcome, 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 everyone. I did not say hi for a long time. I hope you understood the topic, people. I hope there's no other doubts. Please let me know if you have any doubts as such. All right. So I think everyone's here. Quickly, people, quickly join the Mentimeter. All you have to do is this. Go to www.menti.com and enter the code 4779368. Quickly do it. Join the Menti and we shall begin the quiz. More number, people. More the fun. Go. Let's go. More the merrier. Yeah, more the merrier, no? Yeah. So when force is perpendicular to displacement, the work done is zero. Sir, why? Because Sneha, the formula is Fs cos theta. The actual formula of work done is Fs cos theta. That is force into displacement is into cos theta. Cos theta is nothing but the angle formed between displacement and the force applied. So cos 90 value is 1. Because of that reason, cos 90 is... cos 90 is 0, not 1. Cos 90 is 0, that's what you'll get as 0. Alright, that's why. Sine 90 is 1, cos 90 is 0. That's what you'll get as 1. Alright, that's why. Yeah, little confusion. Alright, so we will quickly do it. I'm going to give you another 5 more seconds. 4, 3, 2, 1, 5 questions back to back. Some amazing questions related to power. So here is your first one. Rocket. Just rocket, people, rocket. Here's the question. Which one of the following is not a unit of energy? Not a unit of energy, all right? Kilowatt, kilowatt hour, joules, newton meter. Which of this is not a unit of energy? Think very carefully in the answer. Is it kilowatt, kilowatt hour, joules per newton meter? Let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go. Let's go. What is momentum? We'll be talking about that, Ayush. We'll be, studying that as well. Momentum and everything, we'll be studying that later on. So don't worry. We'll clear that up. Don't worry. Okay. Awesome. Here is your percent. Oh, I was actually expecting this. People. Let me explain this question. All right. Now, what is work done? Work done is force into displacement. What is energy? If you remember, energy is the capacity to do work. So the unit of energy and the unit of work done is the same. If you think about it, force is Newton and displacement is meter. The unit, because what is energy? The capacity to do work. If you don't have energy, you can't do work. So it's basically correlated or it's interrelated. So you can say that Newton meter is also one more form of, it is one more unit of energy itself. Yes, joules is also one more unit. Kilowatt hour is also one more unit. But kilowatt is not. Kilowatt is the unit of power, not energy. It is a unit of power and not energy. And hence, people, the right answer is option number A. Disappointing. 10 of you guys out of the 30 gave the right answer. 19 of you guys unfortunately went with Newton meter, but that is not, people. Newton meter is also one more unit, but power, kilowatt is the unit of power, and hence option number A would be the right answer. I thought at least a lot of you guys will get it right because of Tukkamar. Like, you know, you're like randomly guessing, like, I think majority will get it right, but unfortunately not. Abhishek sir, however, got the right answer. Not unfortunately, fortunately. Now, Aryan, Swayam, Avinash, Milishik, once again, congratulations, the fastest to answer. Praneel, Praneet, Surya, the legend, Archie, and Samuel, congratulations. Well done, that is a good number, but still could have been avoid that one silly mistake could have been easily avoided. It's a silly mistake. It's not like you guys didn't know about it. You guys knew about it. It's just like you should have thought a little now, just a little, and you've given the right answer. It's okay. Eighth question, people. Sorry, the fifth question out of the eighth question. Here we go. Once again, the question is, what is the SI unit of power? Such an easy question. Which is the SI unit of power? Your options are watt, joules, or newton. If you get this wrong, no. You know, you've seen that movie, right? Matrix, where they start shooting people. I'm going to start throwing pens on you people now. If you get this one wrong, after listening to almost 1 hour, if you get this wrong, no, that's all. Okay. Awesome. That's what I'm talking about, people. That's what I'm talking about. 31 of you guys gave the right answer. That is an amazing, amazing number. Still two of you guys got it wrong. I don't know who that two is, but respect, brother. Respect. One of you guys for joules and one of you guys for newton as well. Wow. But the right answer is definitely watt, people. It is nothing but joules per second, which is nothing but watt. Well done, guys. Here is your leaderboard at the end of that fifth question, and everyone in the top 10 got the right answer. So I don't know who are those two people who got it wrong. But nonetheless, Abhishek sir still on the top. Aryan, who is the first one to follow, his wife, Avinash, Milishi, Praneel, Praneet, Surya, Archie, and Palak as well. Beautiful, guys. Beautiful. That is an amazing number. That's almost like 95-96%. Beautiful, guys. Sixth question for the day. Almost done. Three more questions and then we'll know who's the winner. Sixth question, here it is. The time required to perform 520 joules of work at the rate of 20 watt is what? What is the time required? All right, they've given you the work done. They've also given you the power as well. Find out what is the time taken. The options are 20 seconds, 26 seconds, 22 seconds, or 24 seconds. Go ahead, guys, come on. All right. Did I miss out any important questions? Yeah, people. By the way, congrats. Thanks a lot, people. Thank you for making it happen. 50,000 subscribers. That is amazing. In just such a short span of time, we reached 50,000 subscribers. Thanks a lot for you guys. I mean, you're the ones who made it happen. So lots and lots of love from our side. From the whole team, thank you for all the support that you guys are giving us. And do not forget to hit the like button, people. Hit that like button. No, like, show some courtesy, show some love, some little bit of love. Alright, let's go. Alright, Avinash, let's see. Oh, yes, Vishrut, yes, buddy, absolutely. Alright, so here we go, people, once again. 28 of you guys were able to give the right answer for this question. Good one, people, good one, absolutely spectacular. A lot of you guys unfortunately did some calculation mistakes, I believe, but yes, the majority is absolutely correct. So how do you solve this question is actually pretty easy. We know that power is equal to work done by time taken, or work by time. So work is given as 520 joules. Time is what you're supposed to find out. Power is nothing but 20 watt. So T is equal to 520 divided by 20, 0, 0 gets cancelled, 224, 2, 6, 12, so it's 26 seconds. Simple question. Congratulations to all those who got it right. If you got it wrong, it's okay. Relax yourself in your exams at least. Do not make such silly mistakes, because these are the questions where you can actually with confidence say that yes, I'll get those marks. So don't make those kind of silly mistakes. Avoid it, right? That is what you should do. Nonetheless, Abhishek sir, Aryan, Swayam, Avinash was the first one. So congratulations, buddy. Millishri, Praneet, Surya, Archie, and Shubhi. Superbly well done. Congratulations, people. With that said, moving on to the seventh question for the day. Almost done. Seventh question, yet another problem. So take your pens and paper, get ready, here we go. The question is, calculate the power of an electric motor that can lift 800 kg of water to store in a tank at a height of 1500 centimeter in 20 seconds. Take acceleration due to gravity as 10 meter per second squared. So once again, the question is, calculate the power of an electric motor that can lift 800 kg of water to store it in a tank at a height of 1500 centimeter, 1500 centimeter in 20 seconds. And the acceleration due to gravity, take it as 10 meter per second squared. Your options are 600 watt, 60 watt, 6 kilowatt, or 60 kilowatt. 25 seconds, let's go people, come on. Let's go. Quickly. All right. Let's go, people. Come on. 10 more seconds. Let's do it. What is the electric power? Calculate the power of the electric motor. Let's go. Almost done. And here we go, people. A lot of you guys did not even answer the question. They're like, sir, it's okay. Look at that. Awesome. 2, 7, 9, and 10. It's like, you know, it's like a step. Either you can take it as an descending order or ascending order from the left to right or right to left. Beautiful. But nonetheless, 7 of you guys, out of so many people who answered, only 7 were able to give the right answer for this question. I understand the confusion. I understand that this might be a little tricky, but it's actually quite simple, people. You know why? Because power is equal to work by time. One of the formulas of work done is nothing but MGH. What is MGH? Remember potential energy? It is work done can also be written as MGH. When you are lifting something up to a certain height, you can write it as MGH divided by time. What is the mass? Mass is 800 kg. Into acceleration to gravity is 10. Height is 1500 centimeter, 1500 centimeter. Convert that to meters, or what will that be? Divided by 100, so that's 15 meters, because 100 centimeters is 1 meter, so that will be 15 meters. Into 15 divided by time taken is what? 20 seconds. Calculate this, you'll get the answer. So 248. So 15 into 400, what is it, people? 15 into 400, what is that? I think that'll be around 6,000. If I'm not wrong, 6,000 watt is what you're gonna get. So convert that to kilowatt, divided by 1,000, you'll get it in terms of kilowatt, so that'll be what, 6 kilowatt. Simple. That's all. Such an easy question. People, that'll be the answer. Yeah, no doubt, that'll be the answer, guys. That's all. How many of you guys made mistakes in the formula? Tell me honestly, cross your hearts and tell me. Touch wood, how many of you guys made mistakes in the formula? That is something that you should never get it wrong, people. Praneel, why? Thank you, buddy. Thank you a lot. A for aluminium, right? Sindhu, okay. Anyways, people, please don't make mistakes in the formula. Right? Even if you make calculation mistakes, it's okay. But I don't want you guys to make, you know, mistakes in the formula. So it's what work done by time. And you can write it as MGH divided by time, or T or time. Calculate it, put on the values, and that's such an easy calculation. If I can do it, Aram, so you can do it, people. That's all I can say. If I can do it, you can also do it. So here it is. Unfortunately, Abhishek sir, Aryan, Praneel, Surya, and Archie chose the wrong answer. Because of that, Abhishek sir goes to the third position, but Swayam on the top, followed by Abhidash was the positive answer, followed by Abhishek sir. There it's Aryan, Milishi, Praneel, Surya, Adarsh, and Archie as well. Congratulations, people. With that said, the last and the final question for the day to finish it all up. The last question, an easy one, just to relax you people, because you guys have been, you know, your blood pressure is all high right now. So let's relax it a little. An electric bulb of 60 watt is used for 6 hours per day. Calculate the units of energy consumed in one day by the bulb. Your options are 0.24 kilowatt, 24 kilowatt hour, 3.6 kilowatt hour or 0.36 kilowatt hour? Very simple question. The electric bulb of 60 watt is used for 60 hours per day. Calculate the units of energy consumed in one day by the bulb. Let's go, people. Easy. All right. Thanks a lot, Ghost. Thanks a lot. Love you guys too. Thank you. All right. Friend request on Nippoji. Focus on the studies. I can send friend request later. All right. Anyways, let's see. Thank you, Karthikeya. Thanks a lot. Thank you, Ghost. Thanks a lot. 18 of you guys were able to get the right answer for this question. Absolutely wonderful, guys. I wasn't expecting that also. That is good. That is absolutely, absolutely good. So how do you solve this question? It's actually quite simple, people, because we know that energy is nothing but power into time. This is the formula. Energy is nothing but power into time. P into T. That is the formula. Direct substitution, guys. You have done this so many times in your, especially the 10th graders who got it wrong, no? 10th grade, you've done it so many times. Energy is nothing but power into time. So power is given in terms of watt. So convert that to kilowatt. So 60 divided by 1000 is what? Because you have to convert to kilowatt. So that'll be 0.006 kilowatt, right? So you have 0.06 into time taken as 6 hours. Multiply that, you'll get it as 0.36 kilowatt hour. That's all this. That's such an easy question, which you can write as 0.36 units as well. So that is the answer, guys. That's all for the day, people. Here is your full and final leaderboard. The heroes of the day, the heroines of the day who made it until the end and gave pretty much every single answer right. Hats off to all of you guys. Beautifully done. Every one of you guys did absolutely well. But Swayam G. What a brilliant comeback. Absolutely wonderful. Followed by Avinash in the second. Third is Abhishek. So fourth is Milishi. Fifth is Aryan. Sixth is Praneet. Then it's Praneel in the seventh. Then it's Archie in the eighth. Shubhi in the ninth. Tenth is Surya the legend. Look out for the shots today. So it'll be put up in the stories. Congratulations once again, Swayam. Beautifully done, buddy. So that's it from my side, guys. This is your homework for today. Let me know what is the answer for this one by the start of the next session. Your homework is very, very important because this is your practice question. Because I know that after the session is done, 99% of you guys will go close your laptops and go chill out or watch some Netflix movies. Rather than that, solve one question just to recap of what we've done in today's session. The question is this. Calculate the electrical energy consumed in joules if a toaster of 60 watt is used for 30 minutes. It's pretty much the same thing, but let me know what is the answer by the start of the next session. That is pretty much it from my side, guys. Thanks a lot for joining. Once again, the link to join the pro subscription course is given in the description as well. It'll be in the pinned comment section as well. So if you open the comment section, you'll find that first. The coupon code is AMEPRO2WILE. The discounts. Once again, thanks a lot for joining. Hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, share some love to all of us, spread the word that we are back with a bang. All the physics sessions are back with a bang. Thanks a lot for joining, people. Let me know whatever doubts you have, we'll try to clear it up. And then once again, thank you for joining, right? So yeah, people, let's go. Yes, I have one back to back again. So does person who get 11th get a shout out? Yeah, Karthike, why not? Shout out to you too, Karthike. Why not? 11th or 100th, it does not matter. All of you guys deserve a hats off for that. Everyone did amazingly well, so hats off for everyone. I know it. Next session is going to be tomorrow. That'll be for, ICSE. Yes, we'll have one short series. I'll be starting over the one short series again because it was discontinued. So tomorrow will be the one short series. I think it'll be of work energy power. So I have to check the topic name. I'm really sure. But tomorrow I'll be coming live. Day after tomorrow also I'll be coming live. So from now on, every week, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, mark your calendars at 4:45. I'll be coming live. So I hope to see you guys. And also check out all the videos that I've been doing because from now on, every live session, I'll also be asking questions from the previous session. So make sure that you watch that. Keep that in your mind as well when you are attending the live session, because I don't want you guys to get the wrong answer and miss out on the leaderboards as well. So make sure that you do that. And yeah, that's pretty much it. All the announcements are done. If there's anything else that you'd like to ask me, you can ask me right now. That is pretty much it. We have 5 more minutes. I'll try to clear as many doubts as I can. And then the rest of it, we'll do in the next one. Yeah. So how to convert EV into VR? Okay. All right. I think it's... All right, I forgot the conversion. All right, I'll just check it. I'm not able to recollect it. I've been flying blind all these days, like, you know, like in the sense, what to say, my memory has become weak for some reason. I don't know why. Like, you know, sitting idle for, because there was no power also. So sitting idly for all these weeks, my brain has become all ruptured. That's what is happening. No worries, but I'll tell you. Don't worry. So India or Pakistan ka number same hota hai kya? What, India or Pakistan? I don't think so. I know. I think there'll be some difference. India is plus 9-1. No, I think in Pakistan it'll be a little different. Yeah? Yes, I am from Kerala, people. I am from Kerala, for all those who are asking. Yes, sure, Devipita, don't worry. I am from Kerala, itself. Don't worry. Yeah, people. So that's pretty much it from my side. I think we'll call it a day for now. Thank you for joining. Kal also we'll have Menti, for sure we'll have Menti. We'll have lots of Menti tomorrow, lots and lots of Menti, because for the whole, we'll be revising the entire chapter. We'll have a lot of Menti quizzes. We'll also be going through the entire chapter as well. So it'll be a good revision for all of you guys. So make sure that you're there for tomorrow's as well. Thank you for joining, people. I'll see you guys in the next one. Take care. Stay safe. Once again, a very, very happy new year for all of those who I did not wish. Stay safe. Lots and lots of love. Thank you for all the support. Once again, thank you for reaching, helping us reach that 50,000 subscribers as well. Make sure that you subscribe to the channel. Hit that lal button. So make sure that you subscribe to the channel. Hit the like button as well. Thank you for joining. If you want to reach out to me personally, you can also reach out to me at anoop.manoharan@vedantu.com. That's my personal email ID. You can send it to me that as well. Thank you for joining, people. So what is the work done if the displacement of the object is infinite? That is not possible. Right? If that is the case, then work done will also be infinite. If that is the case, but that is not possible. How can, because obviously because of friction, there'll be loss of energy happening, and so the displacement will eventually, you know, it'll eventually stop, because there'll be loss of energy happening. You know, for example, if I kick a ball, it'll not go on forever. It's not Shaolin soccer. It'll go for some time and it'll stop. Obviously it'll stop. So when that is happening, obviously there's loss happening, and hence it will definitely stop. So I can measure the distance. So yeah, that'll be the case. All right. Where to post the answers? You can put it up in the comment section now. The comment section below, no? Put it down, and I'll see that in the next session. Alright, people? So that's it from now. For now, thank you for joining. I'll see you guys in the next one. Take care of yourself. Stay safe. Bye-bye, people. Good night. Thank you for all the support once again. I'll see you guys soon. Bye-bye for now. Enjoy yourself. Take care, guys. Bye-bye. See you all. Yes. See you all. Bye-bye, guys. Take care.